I'm John Hart. I'm Director of Research and Collections here at the New York State Museum, and by training, I'm an archaeologist. Over the past 15 years, I've been working on finding out the histories of the three sisters here in New York. The three sisters are maize, or Indian corn, beans, and squash. Back in the early 1960s, the museum excavated a site in the Susquehanna River Valley called the Round Top Site. And at that site, they recovered fragments of maize, of Indian corn cobs, squash seeds, and pieces of bean seeds. For decades, archaeologists accepted that the Indian corn, the beans, and the squash from the Round Top site were the earliest occurrence in eastern North America for those three crops together at around 1000 AD. Something I noticed in our archaeological collection is that many pieces of broken pottery or pottery sherds from prehistoric sites have a black crust on the inside. What this is cooking residue from when people were cooking in the pots. Parts of what they were cooking burned on the inside. Colleagues working in Central and South America have been able to extract small pieces of silica, or like quartz, that form and plant walls from these cooking residues. Another thing we're able to do is obtain radiocarbon dates, accelerator mass spectrometry dates, on the cooking residue. And what we found was that this particular sherd now has the oldest evidence for maize, Indian corn, in eastern North America. The phytoliths that we extracted from the cooking residues are maize phytoliths, and the radiocarbon date we obtained on the cooking residue is 300 BC, which is 1,300 years earlier than we previously thought maize was in New York State. These are pottery sherds from another site that was excavated in the 1960s by the museum. 40 years later, I came back and looked at the cooking residue on this particular piece of pottery. Turns out that the pottery dates to 1100 BC and that this cooking residue contains squash phytoliths. That means we know squash was present in New York being used by native peoples 2,100 years earlier than we had previously thought. The museum's collections include over 4 million archaeological artifacts. One of the reasons we keep these artifacts is that we can always go back to them and learn new things about the way people lived in the past.